My name is Devin Durbin. So today in the shop here at the Durbin compound, I think what we're going to do is build some cheap sawhorses that don't suck. So I originally got this idea from Kyle over at RR Buildings. He did an awesome project with his son. They built some sweet sawhorses. I think I'm going to put my own little spin on it. I think I want to cut a couple little angles on the legs, and I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to do it. This cost all of, I think, under 20 bucks. So if you've ever gotten the little plastic or metal brackets for sawhorses and zapped them together with drywall screws, you found out that there's a lot to be desired, and they're just not sturdy. They don't hold up well. Yes, they might stack. Yes, they might tear down easy, but they just all around don't do a good job. So how about you just buy the wood, put some time in, and make some cheap sawhorses that don't suck. So today what we're doing is six pieces that are 4 foot long. We're gonna build a little I-beam. I thought that was an awesome, awesome job, Kyle. That's a great idea, and it has a great way of pocketing those legs into it as well. So the legs, we're gonna make 8 of them at 32 inches. First things first is we need to cut our lumber. All right, now that we got all of those boards cut, I went ahead and went with some different dimensions. I thought 48 inches was a little too long, so I took it down to 42. So I took 6 inches off the top for the crossbar there. That'll give me plenty of working room if I'm working with 2x12s, or I want my miter saw up on it. I'll have plenty of room to be able to do a lot of stuff over a sawhorse this wide. I really like that aspect of it. As far as the legs, I went with a 36-inch leg to kind of bring it up high. So when I'm working on my miter saw, I don't have to bend down, and I'm not overreaching or overextending while working with my miter saw. So next thing to do is to drill some holes and run some screws and put this project together. So we need that drill and impact. All right, now you have your drill and impact. What you want to do is pre-drill all of your holes. I usually use an 1/8-inch bit to pre-drill for all drywall screws. So we're going to go ahead and make our I-beams. I'm going to bring you in close, some close and personal, and we're going to make the I-beam cross members, and then we're going to attach the legs. So I had burnt up my table saw while trying to cut the legs, so it kind of gave out on me, so we might not do a miter cut. Might do them exactly how Kyle built them. So let's get down to it. All right, first things first, we're gonna drill 4 holes here. I'm gonna keep my holes spaced out towards the end. And then all I'm using is some 3-inch coarse drywall screws here. Flip over and do the same thing. All right, so I was going to bevel this, the legs here at a 45 degree angle, but I think I'm gonna leave them alone. I think I have to leave them alone because my table saw took a crap on me. So it needs new brushes, and I'm gonna go ahead and just put the legs in here. We're going to screw them into place and get it going. So let's put the legs on this bad boy. All right, now we're going to square up our legs here. Thank you. right, guys, so there you have it. Some cheap sawhorses that are pretty awesome. They'll withstand the test of time. You might need to trim a little bit off your legs if you weren't all that precise in the cutting procedure. When you cut them to length and they weren't all the same, there might be some trimming on the legs that you might need to do. Figure out what leg is longest or that's throwing you off. Putting the square in the elbow of each leg is very important. Make sure you get that leg straight as far as it goes with the sawhorse, so that you know, your leg is going down straight to the ground. Very important step. Now, I'm just going to take the random orbital sander. I'm going to sand all my edges, smooth it down, make it real nice and finished. If I ever want to use this as a platform for a miter saw, I can always stagger these. One thing I did figure out with my shop floor is that if I have the table or the sawhorse like this, it's way out of balance. And I'm like, man, did I cut it that bad? Is it really that bad? And then I turn it this way, and it sits up. It sits great. So it's like, okay, the sawhorse is fine this way, but if I turn it this way, it rocks like crazy. So there's a high spot or a low spot. I don't know, but I did figure that out. Got a little bit flustered. It's 85 here in the shop. I think I've sweat enough today for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you like it, give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs down if that's what you're into, whatever. Tell me how bad I suck in the comments. I always enjoy reading that stuff. So, as always, a nice, cool video. Some man stuff going on here around the shop. And, you know, if you guys like this kind of stuff, put it in the comments. Interact with me. I'd love to talk to you. As always, I hope to see you subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.